Hello everyone, my name is Aubrey Fontenot and I chose to do my research project on light technology for skin rejuvenation. I picked this topic because after I graduate in December, I am actually going to attend Aveda starting in January to study esthetology and then following that become a licensed esthetician. So esthetology is the study of skincare and it's something I've always been very interested in. So using light technology for skin rejuvenation is becoming a very popular trend. It offers non-surgical options for improving the texture and tone of skin, and most times these procedures are performed in a series, so it takes more than one time to get the wanted result. However, each procedure doesn't take a very long time and they come with little to no pain. So what I mean by light technology, specifically I mean lasers. So there's a lot of different treatments you can use for different skin issues, and there's different lasers that go with each skin treatment to help a specific issue, and that's what I'll be talking about today. So one of the most common reasons why people want laser treatments is for unsightly blood vessels and redness. This includes things like rosacea, spider veins, and cherry angiomas. This treatment uses the pulse dye laser that is used specifically for blood vessels and is one of the earliest lasers used for treatment of vascular lesions. There's also the neodymium YAG laser that is an effective treatment for vascular lesions. The second reason people look to light therapy is for treatment of facial pigmentation, or what most people like to refer to as age spots. The most common way this is treated is by using non-ablative lasers, which means that the surface of the skin remains intact and unharmed, and treatment is provided by creating heat under the skin. The intense pulse light is what takes care of this issue. This laser is operator dependent, meaning that the improvement of the condition depends on the choice of the cutoff filter. So this laser has larger head pieces and smaller head pieces depending on what treatment is needed or what the physician or dermatologist decides. The treatment depends on what they decide to use. This treatment also results in immediate darkening of the lesion, which then sloughs off over the next several days. So it takes a couple days to see actual improvement. It's like one of the treatments that you see it get worse and then it gets better. The third most common reason for light therapy treatment is for skin tightening. So this treatment works by causing a thermal injury in the dermis. Keywords are thermal injury. It's non-ablative, so it doesn't cause an actual injury to the skin. It's a thermal one. It results in collagen shrinkage and remodeling. The lasers used for this treatment are radio frequency, ultrasound, and infrared light, and they all work by targeting the dermal collagen. They produce thermal effects without causing cutaneous wounds, and the benefit of this treatment is that there's no downtime and that most skin surfaces can be treated this way, such as the neck, the chest, areas with stretch marks, and this treatment is completely non-invasive. So here's just a couple examples of before and afters of different laser treatments, and you can see in the pictures that these people actually had really great results and the treatments were very effective for them. So that's all I have for my presentation. I hope that everyone enjoyed learning about light therapy for skin rejuvenation, and I hope that maybe I sparked some interest in learning more about it for everyone.